Hello friends, welcome to another video of Dr. Pharma. In this video, we will discuss about the disease scleroderma, which is otherwise known as the sclerosis. The scleroderma is a rare disease that involves the hardening and tightening of the skin and connective tissues. The scleroderma affects women more often than men and most commonly occurs between the ages of 30 and 50. While there is no cure for scleroderma, a variety of treatments can ease symptoms and improve the quality of life. There are many different types of sclerodermas. In some people, scleroderma affects only skin, which is known as a localized scleroderma, and otherwise known as morphea. But in many people, scleroderma also harms structures beyond the skin, such as blood vessels, internal organs, and the digestive tract, which is a systemic scleroderma. Let's discuss about the symptoms of scleroderma in detail. Scleroderma signs and symptoms vary depending on which parts of your body are affected. In skin, nearly everyone who has scleroderma experiences a hardening and tightening of patches of skin. In fingers or toes, one of the earliest signs of systemic scleroderma is Raynaud's disease, which causes the small blood vessels in your fingers and toes to contract in response to cold temperature or emotional distress. When this happens, your fingers or toes may turn blue or feel painful or numb. Raynaud's disease also occurs in people who don't have scleroderma. In heart, lungs or kidneys, scleroderma can affect the functions of heart, lungs or kidney to varying degrees. These problems, if left untreated, can become life-threatening. Let's discuss about the treatment of scleroderma. Getting pain relief through non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications or corticosteroids. Easing skin itchiness with skin lotions and moisturizers. Slowing skin thickening and minimizing damage to the internal organs with the medication that suppress the immune system. Maintaining the muscle strength through physical therapy and exercise. Managing digestive tract function to optimize nutritional intake. Controlling blood pressure and improving blood flow with medications. Improving emotional state through counseling and other measures.